This right here is one of the greatest hip hop albums ever. Hey everybody, welcome back to another edition of Rewind, Relive, and Review. We do music, movies, and TV reviews, and today I got a great one for you. As a matter of fact, I'm talking about, in my opinion, one of the greatest hip-hop albums ever. This one is from Public Enemy. It takes a nation of millions to hold us back. Now, this is one of those albums that I actually had this on cassette. Back in the day, that's what we had, kids, cassettes in our cars. And I ran that album so much that it got chewed up in the cassette player. Eventually, I ended up getting it on CD, and I'm glad I did. Because this, again, can't stress it enough, greatest hip-hop album ever. Let's get into it.
Everybody in the house, make some noise! Yo, Chuck, kick it to him, man!
Okay, so let's talk about Public Enemy during this iteration of the group. At this time for this album, the principals, of course, were Chuck D, who is the main MC, Flavor Flav, who's the hype man. He's also a multi-instrumentalist, piano, keyboards, drums, percussion, and bass guitars. There's also Terminator X, who's the DJ and the producer, and Professor Griff, the Minister of Information, who leads the S1Ws, which is the security of the First World. Now, Public Enemy formed back in 1985, but It Takes a Nation of Millions to Hold Us Back is the second studio album for this American hip-hop group. It was released back in June of 1988, and the group set out to make a hip-hop equivalent to Marvin Gaye's What's Going On, which is an album noted for its strong social commentary. It Takes a Nation of Millions to Hold Us Back charted for 47 weeks on the US Billboard 200. It peaked at number 42 and was certified platinum in 1989. This album received widespread acclaim from critics who praised its production techniques and the socially and politically charged lyricism of the lead MC Chuck D. This album to this day is regarded by music writers and publications as one of the greatest and most influential albums of all time. Not just hip-hop, but albums in general of all time. It is definitely in my tops, and I strongly believe it is still the greatest hip-hop album of all time. Hit me with a comment below. Let me know if you agree, and if you don't agree, what do you think is the greatest hip-hop album of all time? Now, throughout this album, Chuck D delivers narratives that are characterized by black nationalist rhetoric and regard topics such as self-empowerment for African Americans, critiques of white supremacy, and challenges to exploitation in the music industry. Let's listen to some of the songs on the album.
How low can you go? Death row? What a brother, no. Once again, back is the incredible rhyme animal, the uncannibal thief. Public Enemy number one. 5-4 said freeze, and I got numb. Can I tell? Back. Caught you looking for the same thing. It's a new thing. Check out this I bring. Uh-oh, the roll below the level, cause I'm living low next to the base.
Come on.
Turn up the radio. They're claiming I'm a criminal. But now I wonder how. Some people never know. The enemy could be the friend guardian. I'm now a hooligan. I rock the party and clear all the madness. I'm not a racist priest to teach the all.
Cause something never had
you. You on the radio. How long you think we gonna allow you to get away with that fool?
He goes on and on.
Until he reaches the coast, tired wide of his own race. Playing them close. Understand this type of music is a play of the clan. You know the pack attack the man with the palm of his hand. Police, wild beast, dogs on a leash. I am a rock hard chewer to the bone, a bone, a bone, full grown, consider me stone. Once again, and I say it for you to know, the troop is always ready. I am Geronimo, your CIA, your CIA ain't kidding. Both K and X
dope jam. But let's define the term called dope, and you're thinking me funky now. No, here is a true tale. Why the ones that deal, all the ones that fail, yeah. You can move if you wanna move. What it prove? It's here like the groove. The problem is this. We gotta fix it. Check out the justice. I got a letter from the government the other day. I opened and read it. It said they were suckers. They wanted me for their army or whatever. Picture me giving a damn. I said never. Here's a land that never gave a damn about a brother like me and myself, because they never did. I wasn't with it, but just that very minute it occurred to me. The suckers had authority.
Okay, there you have it. That's my opinion. Tell me what you think the greatest hip-hop album ever is. Leave me a comment and let me know. If you like Public Enemy like I do, let me know what your favorite Public Enemy song is. As always, like, share, subscribe. Please, stay positive, stay blessed. I'll see you again in the next video.